this topic because it brings a lot of value to our businesses. So, and it's of course in management and business development, that's applied to everything. You can apply to your team if you manage a team. If you have a business, you can apply to your business. You can use it everywhere. So let's start with this. I mean, it's a fascinating topic. This is really, really beautiful. And I've put here a picture of a little baby, and this old gentleman really, really stressed out of his work and everything. He's the manager, obviously. But I want to ask you, how do you think thinking processes are different in those two characters? How do you think that the baby thinks? If, let's say, I ask the baby, what is that? How the baby will react to this, and how the adult person will react to this?
Well, the baby will react intuitive.
Intuitive. Like it will say, ah! Oh, and why?
Because it doesn't have any perceptions.
Wow. Great. Perceptions. That's the word. I mean, I have it in the next slide. So, yeah, I mean, that's an empty brain. It's simple. That's an empty brain. I mean, there is nothing. So we all been babies, of course. I mean, when we will be grown individuals. And the more we grow, the less, how can I name it, like the less able or willing we are to innovate in our brain. The baby can innovate a lot. Absolutely. I mean, it reacts intuitive. So I've put a really, really simple game here. I'm sure everyone can read it. Let's give us like 1 minute. If some of you has the answer, okay, please keep it. It took me 30 minutes to understand this. I was really mad at my brain, honestly. Why my brain fooled me like this? So let's give ourselves like 1 minute or 2 minutes. And if you have any suggestions, just raise your hand. And we will get the microphone and then we'll let you talk. Or if you don't want the microphone, you can talk. Look, this problem can be solved by preschool children. I don't see any of them here. Okay, keep it. Two people. Let's wait for a third one, fourth one. Okay, we have a lot of people. Okay.
Six.
Six what? Six?
Is the answer.
Why?
I was just adding the numbers.
Okay, can you which numbers you were adding?
I was adding the 25.
No, it's wrong. 25. Wrong. No numbers. You. This guy has FCA, level 3. CFA, sorry. No, FCA is different. Financial code, yeah, okay, sorry, because I had the other one, the Financial Conduct Authority in UK, sorry. So, yeah?
Two.
Two? Why?
I count the circle.
Okay. That's the answer? Okay. So, you are looking.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. Yeah, you see, so you are looking at numbers. You are trying to find a mathematical correlation. Yeah. And you escaped from this. What's your name?
I'm Denica.
Denica. Okay, so. How did you know the answer or?
No.
So how come did you went out of the perceptions, Christiana?
Let her say.
Okay.
Well, I saw the second number and the third one.
Is that 00?
Yes.
No circles around.
Yes.
You have four here.
Yes.
You have two. Mm-hmm. Who? What's the logic and what's the analogic behind all this? Why our brain, because most of us, I mean, I stared at it, you were really good, because it took me 30 minutes to understand this, you know, I mean. Why do you think that we act like that? Because we're not babies?
Yeah.
Because
we are overcomplicating things.
We are overcomplicating things?
Because we are trained to look at that thing, the digits in a specific way.
True. Exactly. So the more we learn, which is really important in our life, of course, we don't want to be dummies. So we need to go to university, we need to learn languages, math, studies, you know, physics, history, all these things. But the more we learn, the more, the less we are able to accept new ideas. I mean, our brain refuses. You say, excuse my friends, but, you know, I don't want this information. You're wrong. So let's go to the other one. That's just the beginning. And you see how we've all been fooled for a while by our brain. So another really, really interesting game. I mean, I'll be playing around with your brains a little. Please don't be angry with me. So I will ask you, how many colors has the rainbow?
Seven.
Who said seven?
Seven.
Why seven? You know it, or your brain know it?
I've read it, but I don't.
Okay, and you said?
Infinite.
Why infinite?
Because we have words to describe color, but the numbers of the words is finite.
Okay, that's...
It doesn't describe all the colors possible. Different system can describe a color in much more detail.
Yes, true, but the simple explanation behind it is, our eyes, I mean, of course, we know that the rainbow, seven colors. But behind that, it's another true. I mean, what we see is not what's out there. The same. I mean, I'm not going to put the picture of that. But do you know the Parthenon in Athens? How many columns? You have the image. Now I said the Parthenon, and I'm sure, bam, in your brain you have this the Parthenon in your mind, right? So how many columns has the front side of the Parthenon?
Four.
13. Wow. That's in Paris, maybe something else. No. How many?
Two.
No. You've been to Athens?
Yeah.
Nikki, come on.
I have been there to the Parthenon. Uh-huh. Four, seven times over.
And you haven't counted the columns in the Parthenon.
But the columns.
Anyway. I'm sure you have an image, but you have an image. It's not 100 and it's not 2, I'm sure. That's my idea. Do you see where I'm coming from? I mean, you have an image in your mind, but you're not sure. But you have something. Your brain is telling you something, perceptions. So many of you will say 7, but it's not true. Anyway, so all these things that we've just explained, How our brain, I mean, I'm not going to be going that deep into the topic explaining, okay, this part of the brain, that part of the brain, this part, like, that's logic, that's love, that's emotions, that's whatever. I don't know these things. But what I know is two simple processes. That's the world that we have here, and that's where we are, all the people around the world. And when we are born as babies, that's empty. We don't have any understanding of the world, which is the process called deduction, or deducing is the verb. The opposite way around, to come from the world to our brain, is induction or inducing. That's obviously a thing that has been that's been developed by great minds. It's not my discovery. Don't get me wrong. But that's really, really simple. Everything that we've just talked about, is here. And this is against the logic, and that's logic. So when we count the numbers, we are deducing. You see here, mental models affect the way we see and interpret reality. They are like filters through which we see the world. The same in the business. The same we do in the business. All the products and services we have. That's a really, really interesting game we play now. You see here, the sentence, an example of a whatever is, that's the deducing. If we answer this, we will be deducing. If we say the same thing is an example of we are inducing. So let's play with a car. If I ask you, an example of a car is, what comes to your mind?
Tesla.
Good job, Tesla. What else? Mercedes? Come on. Okay, what else?
BMW.
Okay, all these brands, obvious. But if I ask, the BMW is example of, or if I ask, the car is example of, what is it?
Vehicle?
Transportation. We just started. That's a completely different thing. Vehicle and transportation are two different concepts, two different simplifications, and we can add more. The example, the car is example of vehicle transportation. What else?
Luxury,
comfort. What else? We can build 10. And all these simplifications build a product and build a service. Do you see what I want to like try to play with it? I mean, it's really interesting. If we try to play it with a telephone, I mean, the telephone didn't look like this 20 years ago. But thank you. Yeah, it was great. He said so many nice things for me, and then I need to buy him many beers now.
Or whiskeys.
Oh, whiskeys. Yeah. Okay. Let's play with the phone. When you say the phone in example is an example of what comes to your mind?
Communication.
Okay, communication. That's nothing to deal with communication anymore. I mean, not the regular way. You see? But that's true. What else? Social status.
Picture. Connectivity.
Connectivity. I'm not going to write all of those, but what else? Come on. Imagine we are at Apple now.
Mobility.
This brand we don't like. What?
Navigation.
Navigation. Yes. So when you say, that's really good. When you say the phone is an example of navigation, which is absolutely mind-blowing. Can you imagine when you had the phone, the first phone, you say navigation, you look at the phone and you say, how this thing will navigate me? It's impossible, but this here will. So that's innovation, that's process of innovation, and probably in 15 minutes we will go through the processes of creativity and innovation, and we'll see how they correlate to each other, like how they interact. So that's how they innovate, basically. Another really simple example, the Apple Watch. Nobody likes it, again, but people are buying it, and they're paying like $1,000 for this, right? I even don't know how much does it cost, but they pay a lot of money. Because when you think of a watch, would you think that you have a computer on your watch, or you have your phone in your watch? It's mind-blowing, again. It's something against the logic. It's rather inducing than deducing. But it is a product, and it's being sold for quite a while, for quite a lot of money. Another thing is the office. And why did I put the office here? Let's play with it. I mean, we are not playing with this. Come on. Don't be shy. Say something like, an example of an office is, what comes to your mind? Hubov. Kubo. Right. That's a good example, actually. You know, Kubo, I mean, I didn't do that intentionally, but I spent my days there, so. I mean, but it turned out to be a good office, so we kind of innovated, you know, without willing to. So, another thing, an example of office is? Cool. Okay, I'll play something else. I mean,
A TV show.
That's interesting. What?
The office is a TV show.
It's the name of the TV show. Okay. So you see, like, your perceptions are different to mine. I don't understand you at the beginning. So you need to go deeper and, like, explain me what you mean. Anyway, why I put that here? In Moscow and in London as well, they're not offices, but coffee. Why we go to Costa or Starbucks? Not for the coffee.
Wireless.
Okay, so that's a need we have. And some entrepreneurial minds got the idea what we need and said, okay, I will make an office that looks like a coffee shop, and I'm not going to charge you for every coffee you buy, but I'm going to charge you per hour for the internet use. And you have that in Moscow and in London. Striking, but it's true. So I've been in London in a coffee shop that I mean, I go there, I pay like £2-3, and I can stay an hour. Yeah, and I use the internet, and I can drink as much as coffee as I want. Of course, I'm not a coffee maniac, but I will drink one. But the amount of people you have there, the comfort you have there, like, it's like a co-working space. I was even thinking to open a co-working space in Kubo next year. Felipe will join me, you know. So that's, I mean, people will be willing to work there, definitely. Nobody wants to stay in office while it's like 35 degrees out there. So that's innovation. Why I put this here? How do you think? I've already named it, actually. The watch is example of what comes to your mind?
Time.
That's the main point, time. The watch is made to show you the time.
Not in Slavic countries?
Not in Slavic countries. You know, you want to see like these big watches like this? That's what you mean?
Somebody already said it's a symbol of your status.
It's, of course, it's always been like this. I mean, in centuries, you have a horse back in the 15th century, you show status because it's not nice to walk from Paris to Marseille. Of course, you want to have your horse and go there. So the same with the watch, with the time, the item that you are equipped with, I mean, of course, with the men, that's really kind of social status stuff. You have your watch. So the watch is example of a status, not only time. So that's how they innovate, these luxury brands. You know, Breitling, that Patek Philippe, nice one, Switzerland. I mean, that's how they build a market niche. And that's how you innovate. I mean, the watch is not a watch anymore, it's something else. So if all the business owners here write those questions here, you need to like think about this a few hours, and you'll come to really fascinating products and services for your businesses, I'm sure. It's impossible not to. And of course, my favorite. Anytime Gillette has a drop in sales, they add another razor blade. Come on. That's not innovation, you know? But they do. And they sell it for an extra euro or whatever. You know, ultra mega faster. Anyway. So what about your business? Can you name, let's say, what kind of sectors? Like, we have a lawyer here, I know. We have a financial professional. We have IT. What else we have? How we can help your businesses have much better product after 1 hour, or the idea of the product, and then in 1 year, you've doubled the sales? I don't have a question. Okay, so deducing is a comfort zone, obviously. A lot of freedom, you have a lot of freedom when you induce. So that's, again, we're coming back to the point. I mean, it's not easy to induce. That's why computer, I want to tell this. I mean, I have it later in the slide, but I want to tell it. That's why machines or computers are not capable to overcome or to be something, what's the right word, to be more powerful than the human being. Because the human being can induce, the machine cannot induce. Yes. It's impossible, not yet, no way. It will be a human being, if it will not be machine. So, another thing, perfect deduction is possible because you know what you have in your mind. But perfect induction, it's impossible. If your boss, or if you are your boss and you want to go and say like, okay, I need to make a market research for my best holiday. I want to go to Barbados or Bahamas or Cuba or whatever. How do you get the best offer? You start browsing the websites. Okay, this is better deal. This is better hotel, but slightly cheaper. But this is a double room. But I want a sea view. But I want a business class. But I want this and that. You will not be possible to induce. Perfect induction is not impossible. I gave the holidays example, but the same with your business. You will not be you will never be possible to analyze all the market opportunities, because by the time you're analyzing, they've been changed. Markets work like that. You understand? You know, it's impossible. And something we are not really good at when we grow is to have hypotheses. We are afraid of this. Our brain is afraid of that. When we are babies, we are curious. When you see, not an old person, but a retired person, what's the type of curiosity they have to read the newspaper? You see them like, give me my coffee and the newspaper, and I'm okay. While we are young, We want to travel, we want to meet people, we want to learn things. So that's, it's so natural, but if you as managers, as owner of businesses, allow yourself to overcome it, I'm sure that you'll be having great, great success in your businesses. Another thing I've just remembered is was it Samsung that put a video wall on the back of a truck?
Yeah. Samsung, yeah.
Exactly. So what did they do? A truck is example of safety. They just smashed the industry and said, we are not talking about transportation anymore. Not about vehicles, not about comfort, not about whatever humanity was thinking about. We're talking about comfort and safety. And this was something that anyone liked, like everywhere in the world. This was viral. And I'm sure, of course, they didn't get a lot of sales immediately, but the brand awareness, come on, it was good. So, this is really interesting. Like, I'm thinking about my girlfriend, let's say. That's possible. Because I know her, whatever I can think about her. But I'm thinking about my clients. The CEO of a big company goes out in a press conference and say, okay, I'm thinking about my clients and they're really important to me and blah, 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 and blah, 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 and we wanna, you know, this and that. Impossible. By the way, do you read this word? Why? Your brain read the word even though it's wrong. No, nobody asked. Huh?
Because we know about the possible before that.
Maybe. So it's logic. Stop deducing. Come on. Stop deducing. I just said, like, let's induce a little bit. Anyway, if you think about it, same in your business. It's impossible for you to, you know, those two differences. Like, you can, people busy, like, oh, I'm busy so much with this and that, and I have that much and this to do. But why is that so? You can think of one thing at a time. It's difficult. You can have few thoughts in your mind, but you cannot focus on all your clients. You cannot know 2 million people. I'm sure you'll agree with me. Same. What do you think of Brazilians? A friend of mine asked me. We have a Brazilian friend. What do you think of Brazilians? What do you think was my answer? Huh?
Which one? Which Brazilian?
No, come on, which Brazilian? No, I don't know them. I don't know all Brazilians. That's the answer. How can I answer something if I don't have an argument for that? I will lie. Because I didn't meet all Brazilians. It's impossible. And again, technology is making us stupid. What do you agree with this, or you disagree?
Depends how you use it. It's a platform. You can use a lot of things. Most people.
I generalize here. That's kind of a generalized question.
Yes.
It makes us stupid. Yes and no. Why?
Yes, because it's making it less necessary to remember stuff.
Okay.
No, because that doesn't. Knowing stuff is not what makes you smart.
Absolutely.
About how you use the information again. So
exactly.
If you don't know that much information, and you gather it and know how to do it properly, you're still not a stupid person.
True. So that's definitely, I mean, no, I don't agree with this. Technology is not making us stupid. It might be making us lazy to think, but it doesn't make us stupid at all. If we know how to use it, everything, I don't want to like scroll back. Everything that we've been through will come to our benefit. So to think creative in a creative way means to forget. This is really difficult. It sounds, again, mind-blowing probably. You're like, oh, this guy's crazy. I mean, bullshit. It's not possible. Why do you want me to forget? Yes, if you forget, you'll become back in time to the stage where you're a baby. And you will be able to see the little circles in the numbers instead of the numbers. And this will allow you to have a new way of thinking. It's not easy again. Your brain will be like, I don't want to do it. Like, no way, no, I've been told not to do this. It's like a reaction, but it will bring benefit to you. I want to pick up one business owner who wants to innovate in his business here. Who wants to innovate? Have a new product. You. Okay, come. So, till the end, we need to have new products for your business.
I'm curious to see how that goes.
Okay, so wait a second now. That's how people innovate. This concept works. This was developed not by me again, this was developed by BCG, Boston Consulting Group. Amazing. Just a simple example. You know the area in France, Champagne, where the champagne comes from? Okay. They needed to raise the sales. And they made a focus group. And the consultant there said, okay, how do you innovate? How do we sell more sales? How do we raise the sales ratio? And they started thinking of new products. So we have champagne. When you the champagne is an example of
drinking
luxury. Okay.
New Year.
Celebration. They said birthday. Or like toasting. This was close. And they said a new feature. And they had a new concept. To make a tailored product for people who, you know, in France, in South of France, it's really popular, it's really nice there. People give toasts, you know, they go for dinner, they roast the lamp, you know, nice. And they have a really, really nice bottle of champagne and they give a toast. And it's not easy to give a toast. I'm not sure how many of you gave a toast. It's not easy at all. A good one in French as well, it's difficult. So they made a little book which was added to the product, they made a really nice pack, they branded it, they've named it, and it took him 2 years to penetrate the market properly, but they've done it, and they raised sales for a particular champagne. And they've been different just because they innovated. They were thinking outside the box. So that's what Yavor needs to do for his business. Like, you have your, what's your service?
We sell
removals.
I was going to refer to the other one because I think it's easier.
Okay, yep.
We sell food directly to people's homes, like local organic grown food to people's homes.
Great, okay. He's a diverse business owner. He doesn't have only one business, you know. Okay, so I will leave this to you. Can you like write your product here? The online store for...
Down here.
Yeah, can you... Down, yeah, you can write it here, we'll go the other way around.
No, we'll do the same way, no problem.
He doesn't want to induce. He's deducing again. We don't start good here.
Like you said, the whole is lazy, so...
Yes, no, I'm joking.
Online store for local organic food.
What is your favorite ancient philosopher? Do you have one?
Mine?
No, I'm sorry. Aristotle, I'll talk about him now. Let's see. Cool, so let's follow this. Can you make like four, you decide how many arrows and you tell yourself or the audience, if someone wants to help him, bring up ideas, that's like welcomed. An example of this is?
An example of an online store for local organic food is, and I write something.
And you think how people associate your product, how they like, what's the mental model that comes to their mind? Like you can do, if you want, you can do like, in order to have many, because I want the audience to participate as well. Okay. Can you help?
Help. Yeah.
Help, okay. Help. So, okay. That's good. The good start, help.
Convenience.
Lifestyle.
Free time.
Okay. What else?
What? Drones.
That's interesting. Okay, drones. If you associate it.
And I think he means delivering the food to people's homes with drones. It's an interesting concept.
Great. So from here, he will go the other way around to new customers, new solutions, and new markets. Simple. But this is inducing. It's not deducing again. You're not deducing. Your brain works against logic. The simplest way to find more interesting words for here is to go against logic. To put water and fire. Like cat and dog. You know, like...
Or cat and fire.
Maybe, yeah. That's bam,
water,
you know.
Water and dog.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, that's against the logic. That's inducing. That's something that is not in your mental model or mine. But you can have... The difficulty with this thing is if you go too far in this, like Apple did with the tablet, for example. I had a friend like 5 years ago. He posted a picture. He put a wallpaper of a wooden table here, onion and a knife. That's what he used the tablet for. He's making jokes. So that's like, you know, I mean, he used it in the kitchen. Because he didn't know what to use it for. Because that's a completely new thing. That's tablet. What you use it? Like, till the market is get used to that, it might take a bit of time. But still, you see, in the end, you will succeed if you do it properly. So let's leave it for now. If you have more ideas, raise your hand or come and write it. And then in 10 minutes, we come back and we see how your business goes, okay?
Bart,
cool.
Thanks for growing my business.
Good. Thank you, Yavor. Woohoo! Okay, innovation in business, forgotten examples by the great philosophers. Parmenides and Heraclitus. This guy, not possible to change. Both of them, 2,500 years ago. Change is necessity. I'm part of this club. I think so. Philip as well. We need to change the office. Anyway, do you know these guys? No, you don't need to know them, but like if you... Dido? Okay. He was with us. Okay. No, why I show this? This problem that we have here with the business has been existing for few millenniums. It's not a new thing, and I'll show you. You know, Heraclitus said, you can't step twice into the same river. You need to change, you need to go out of the comfort zone, you need to induce, not to deduce. Simple. So, when humanity started building airplanes, what did they do? They look at the bird, because that's deducing. They don't induce, they don't know how to build a plane. And they say, okay, I look at the bird flies. What it does? This movement. What happened to this guy? I mean, this plane never took off. Because they were deducing. Innovation, that's again innovation. So what's the difference between, you can have creativity and innovation. So, sorry. You can have innovation without creativity and creativity without innovation. What's the difference between both? One of them, the creativity, requires thinking. You need to think of the new mental models that we did here. But the innovation, the process of innovation, requires action. So Yavor now needs to go back to his office and do the things. Otherwise, somebody else will do these things for him, you know? So the capacity of a company to change the reality, to change the market, to launch a new product, that's innovation. You might have a great idea. You know, like the mouse, the computer mouse, was invented by Xerox. It was not done by Microsoft. I mean, the patent is owned by Xerox. But which is the company making billions of this? It's not Xerox. Xerox are selling print machines and printers. So you see here, somebody had an idea, mothers, but somebody else did the money. So when it comes to business, if you have a great idea, you need to have action on it. So anyway, I mean, here, you see, that's completely different. Obviously, when people were creating planes and everything, they wanted to fly over the Atlantic instead of sailing. They tried this because they copied the bird. But it didn't work. So they needed to induce. So the light bulb is not an improved candle. Simple. I mean, that's a completely different thing. You cannot ask me, okay, that's a candle. I mean, how do we make the bulbs now? It's easy for us because we have this in our mental model since the day we are born, since the day we are babies. The baby is not asked, okay, that's a candle. What do I do with that? Like, you have the lights. You remember what was like 100 years ago? How people gave signals when they wanted to, like with the cars, to turn left and right. They had these sticks. But that's completely different thing, mind-blowing, to put a light. It's not an item that gives the signal. It's a light. So if we innovate, if we induce, we go in another direction. Instead of item giving a signal, we go light giving a signal. Same with this, like, Simon, have you seen in London these umbrellas that is just a stick? It sucks the air from below, it blows it up, you don't have anything. Have you seen this here? I mean, I was shocked when I saw. I saw a guy walking with a stick, you know? And there is nothing. I mean, he's protected. Like, the water goes like this. Because it's like, it's a stick that sucks the old air and blows it really rapidly, really, like, strong. And he's protected. That's umbrella. That's your concept of umbrella. That's completely different thing. Nothing to deal with the regular umbrella you know about. So when we innovate in this business model, we put umbrella and we write air. Or, you know what I mean? It's not a regular umbrella. And here, would you think that you have stairs moving up and down? Or elevator, a room moving up and down? When the humanity started building skyscrapers, they needed to lift people up and down because there was no space. So they needed an elevator. And that's how they innovated, by need. But sometimes, if you don't innovate by needs, you innovate because you want to, in order to lead. So here is the creativity, the skill of somebody who easily change his or her perceptions. As you said, mother here. That's a change of perceptions. That's the process of thinking. That's not the action. That's not how the business will be built, but that's what you do before the action. You have the thinking process. Okay, that's great example, I love it, of innovation and creativity. Totally wrong for this guy. Do you know him?
Yes.
Now they've taken the name. Anyway, you're either victim of the change or you lead the change. And of course, when you start a new business, everyone will come to you and tell you, all your things are bad. Come on, that's a really, really bullshit idea. I mean, you shouldn't be doing this. But this guy, I mean, you know his story. You know the AC/DC, not the band. You know? Exactly. And who invented the alternative current? And this guy, you know his name?
Thomas Edison.
And you know Westinghouse, the company? Which is nowadays consulting businesses around the world for billions. They had a fight. I mean, they didn't go well because this guy stole his ideas and made billions. You can read about it after that if you want. Just type those names and see the story. This guy died in a hotel in New York, absolutely bankrupt. Despite he had great ideas. He innovated. Sorry, he actually had a creativity stroke, but not. He didn't innovate. He didn't do the action style stuff. So I'll play a game here. Again, that's maybe some of you saw that. Do you think that the color of this and this is the same or is different? Is the same. Why?
Seeing some pictures and I know how.
You know the game? How many of you have done this? So, you go regular to trainings. The fact is the following. They look different, but when we put and get the other restrictions of our mind away, they are the same. They're the same color. The same in the business. Do you know what is that?
Palindrome.
What?
A palindrome.
A palindrome.
Yeah.
What is that?
A number that could be read from the both sides the same.
Bam! My God, what the hell? Well done! I don't know what is that. I don't know what is that, honestly. I will come back to the other one, but do you know what is that? Kremlin. Kremlin.
Scribble.
Ah, scribble. Yeah, it is scribble, but it says something. Can your mind read that? Can your mind deduce? Manhattan. Manhattan. And that is the code of Manhattan. Because, you know, where live a lot of people. Before, when the phone was not that type of phone, you needed to dial. And if it's 9, it takes a bit of time. 9, 9, so these guys in Manhattan said, come on, guys, we are rich people here. We do business. We want 212. So they took this code back in time to save a bit of time, you know. But your mental model said, I even don't remember what you said, honestly. Okay. Unbelievable. Can you read this?
Science.
Everyone read science?
Yes.
How did you read it? Normally, our brain, exactly, yeah, you can do this, all this crazy stuff. But our brain, I mean, we've been told and we've been learning at the university or at school that we need to read not the empty spaces, but what's filled with color. And here, it's the opposite. We need to read the empty spaces. Our brain is not meant to read the empty spaces. All these examples are examples of deducing, of deduction. And in order to decode them, you need to induce. Again and again and again. Something I really like, you have it always in business. You have a meeting with your team, you have one guy with one idea and another guy with another idea. Bam, these guys are fighting. Why? Because that's a paradox. Trigger of creativity. So it's good to have teams. Sorry, I broke this. Trigger of creativity. How do you see this, Will? Huh?
Both sides.
Both sides. Are you angry at me now? Because I'm like playing with your mind. I mean, this is really like, you look at it and it's like, something's not right with this. I mean, I don't like this picture, you know, it's like, how come when I look at it halfway, it's that side, and you know, it's not nice. You have these things in business. You look at something, it looks logical, but at the same time, if you put something unlogical on it, it also has sense. And you are wondering what to do with that. Okay. Can you read that? But that's A, and that's H. Sorry, that's H, that's A. Sorry, that's H, that's A. Why we read the cat? It's so easy. Now you're really angry at me, huh? With this. How we get away, challenge assumptions. How we get away this upper part, away from the lower part. Your brain like this way, that way, up, doesn't go, maybe that way, maybe that side. Do you have suggestions how to take it out? Huh? Just up? No, it won't go. It won't go because, you see, at the bottom.
Slide it, yeah.
Slide it? But if you have the same thing here, would you be able to slide it? Do you know if you have the same thing behind?
Maybe it's not solid.
We don't know what's here. When we see this, okay, we have an idea, but we don't know what to do. Same in business. I want all of us here to associate all these things with business, with any, like with water, with the flowers, with pens, with chairs, with wooden, with carpets, with light, with desk, with business conferences. How to innovate in business? Possibility, lazy brain, and simplification, of course. So, what do you think is the shape of the lower box? Huh? They're what? So your brain makes lazy assumptions again. Ah, I don't have the slide. Sorry, guys. It was really interesting. So, your brain will see what your eyes don't see. Of course, but is it always true? Your brain will build what is not accessible for your eyes. So what you don't see, you make a presumption, again by the deduction. Sorry, actually, I didn't mention. I was reading the Time magazine the other day when we were talking about the airplanes. Where do you think is the safest area in the airplane? Come on, you look at my magazine. Why then business class is so expensive? Because business class is always in the front.
You get out of the plane first.
It's an assumption.
It's an assumption. But theoretically, if you sit here and the backside, it's been proven by all the people who had accidents or whatever, that that's the safest area. But this is where people sit and they pay a lot of money. We all do. It's against logic. It's innovation. It's inducing. It's not deduction. But it works perfectly fine in business and it makes a lot of money. Okay, I've told about this. Let's say about marketing. That's something I like. How many of you are dealing with marketing? Okay, great. So, what do you give a lot of money? Like, what you bring a lot of value? That's absolutely the same idea as this business flights. What would you pay for more? The diamond or the water?
No, it depends which year it is.
What do you mean by this? Why? I'm sure that 200 years ago, you go wherever you want, they show you a diamond, you kill the person to get the diamond.
Especially in America,
yeah. Sorry, what? Okay, in the very same country. True. No, it's true. But in that very same country, I'm sure that if you find a person you love there, and this person comes and offer you marriage and give you this, it will pay more for that instead of the water.
Right now, yes.
Exactly. That's my point. Why is that so?
Diamonds are not the...
You're going to die if you don't have water.
Diamonds are forever.
No. Diamonds are forever. Yeah, okay. So you're in the desert. You look at the water and the diamond, bam, you get the diamond, you know. Come on. Look at this. This is a really beautiful picture I've done in an island. I've been in a holiday, and I was looking at this seagulls. How they fly. What they've done was really amazing. Like, they've stayed like this without moving. I've showed it, like, they do it here in Varnes. Well, wherever you have seagulls and a strong wind, they do. Like, they stay still. That's a really interesting concept by Immanuel Kant. So when I saw them, I immediately thought of this. Because this guy says, the problem of the bird is the air. Because it blows in front of the bird. I mean, it's a problem. I mean, left, right, I mean, you need to balance. But again, this is the condition of the flight. You cannot have a flight without air. I will leave this to you, how you interpret this to your businesses. What problem does your business solve? And do you fly? Like the birds? Think about it. Or you do just the regular things. You go to this startup weekend and you do a new app, please. We have billions of those apps now. How would you sell this? It's so difficult to penetrate the market. Do something more interesting. So, no, it's true. Constraint and creativity, how they work together. This is, who is Aristotle here? Huh? This guy. nice beard, yeah? Okay, this is Galileo Galilei. Look at the when they lift. It's a huge gap, isn't it? Like two yeah, thousand. Well, this is BC.
It's almost 2000.
Yeah, 2000. Yeah. Ah, I heard 200, sorry. Sorry. Okay. This guy and this guy as well, they didn't have computers, they didn't have any tools to measure or prove and solve problems, but they did quite effectively. I'll play with one with them. This guy, Aristotle, said, if you have a heavier body, an item, if it falls down, it will fall faster than a lighter body. Do you agree with this? No? It depends. Let's presume equal conditions. Equal conditions. Let's say you put them in a, you go to Empire State Building and you have two iPhones and you drop them. Which one will fall faster if you have a two iPhones or one iPhone?
They fall with the same velocity.
Why?
Same speed. Because of gravity and usually they have the same form and the air is...
How do you prove this? It's true. How do you prove this back in this year?
You go up to the Leaning Tower of Pisa and throw shit off of it.
That's what he did. That's what this guy did. Exactly. He took two bricks, equal size. When you match them together, they become the size of a big one, the same as this one. He stood up and said, I'm going to let them fall. And he did it. And they fall with the same speed. Simple, but effective way to prove and solve a problem and challenge a theory which was used for 2,000 years. It was said, bam, you know, when you have a bigger item, an object, it falls faster. But it wasn't true. Despite the fact that for 2,000 years, all the humanity taught the opposite. What about the current situation we live in? Would it be something out there that's not what quite like what it looked like? You know, I mean, there could be something we might think about. I'm not sure if I need to talk about this actually, because I did this training in Istanbul and it was a bit different. I decided to leave that slide. And do you know who is this guy? Obviously it's written who, but do you know him? Musa Keita, first emperor.
Who was the richest person who ever lived?
Who ever lived on the planet. Like, if we take Bill Gates now, he will be maybe in Forbes, the 20th, this will be the top. You know? Why? Again, because of creativity and innovation. He lived in Africa. Nowadays, the poorest continent on Earth. Despite, though, like, you have a lot of resources out there. That's an interesting map. You have, like... That's color-coded, and you have few things written over. So you have, of course, petroleum products, oil, copper, outsourcing, coffee, and gold, and diamonds, water all around. But capital goods in America, motor vehicles, transport equipment. Look at Europe. Why the hell this little continent is so rich? Why Switzerland? Why Switzerland is such a rich country? What are the products? Do you have oil? Do you have copper? Do you have gold, diamonds, cotton, iron? Let's take Portugal. That's a really good example. When I was in Lisbon, Felipe gave me a good lesson. But history lesson, I mean. You know, you look at Portugal nowadays. I mean, before, when I lived in Portugal, actually, I was like, look at the stories in history. I studied there. Okay, you take Brazil, you have Namibia, Angola, Mozambique, you have Cape Verde here, you have, what was that, East Timor? Yeah. How the hell Portugal was not that rich at that time? You have Spanish Empire, you have the British Empire, exactly. How do you innovate to conquer this piece of land with the size of Europe? And exploit it for financial reasons. What?
You get there first?
Okay, if I go there first and you go there second, do you think you're going to succeed there?
At that time, Portugal was not that poor.
Well, it was poor compared to Spain, to the Spanish kingdom.
Spain.
Not poor, I mean, but they didn't have the resources.
Good diplomats, you made the agreement.
Good diplomats. They just made love. They just made love. You know, that's for free. You don't need a weapon. Felipe, thank you for this lesson. But really, I mean, they made love. That's true. They didn't have any diplomats. They didn't have any influence. They just went there and mixed the blood. And they have this piece of, that's innovation, isn't it? You think about it that way. But again, why I show this? Let's go back to the GDP map. Nominal GDP per capita. Source, International IMF, 2008. It's not really actual, but I didn't think they changed a lot. So look at the GDP. Here, Europe. Here, this piece of land. I have one theory that countries which have higher temperatures are poorer than countries who have lower temperatures. Why is that so? Because, I mean, today Simon goes to the beach. There is a lot of business going on here, but he doesn't stay here. He goes to the beach. Why? A simple reason. Look at this map. Where are the resources? Where King Musa Muta developed this kingdom with all the resources, which is absolutely logical. But after two millenniums, you have financial centers in London, in New York, in Tokyo, and in Singapore. Singapore, it's not even on the map here in 2008, but now, or Hong Kong. Why is that so? Because of innovation, because businesses, because people think, and I can get your resources and use them for my benefits if I innovate. That's the idea worldwide. So can you please come now? I want to play the music. You're going to like it, I'm sure.
Thank you. It's known by that the BCG consulted this company to innovate with a new product. They have fascinating things. Honestly, video and music radios. And it's much, much more better than MTV or VH1 or whatever, because they mix everything that other channels can. And because of this, they can make more money. You know how the advertising industry works. So that was for me. I'm on time. For first time.